Paolo Campoli. I'm the Chief Technology Officer for the Service Provider segment for Cisco in Europe, Middle East and Africa. And I also run Middle East and Africa Global Service Provider Sales. That I've seen today, that was my first time at AfricaCom, and it's pretty impressive to see a couple of trends that are visible probably sooner here in Africa than say in Western Europe or the Middle East, which is the quest for more partnership between service providers and say over-the-top players. Today at the plenary session there was a presentation from Facebook, presentation from Twitter, presentation from service providers like MTN, like Airtel, and there was a clear statement of intent from both parties. And instead of competing or having a cannibalization play, there is much more appetite for true collaboration for two reasons. One is to basically address together a broader market, and the other one is to create value rather than squeezing value from one side to the other. The interesting element when you think about Cisco is what we bring to this type of combination. We're trying to make service provider infrastructure, either data center or broadband, for optical transport, much more application aware. So getting the world of application closer to the world of infrastructure, broadband infrastructure. And we are trying to make networks way more programmable by a new generation of talents that can basically program networks and develop applications directly on the network platform. So when you think about the partnership between carriers, service providers, and over-the-top players, having a programmable network platform, having application velocity, these are key enablers for this new business model. Whether the business model will bear fruit, we are positive about that. Of course, the debate has been ongoing for many years, but we believe we are at the point where that type of combination is happening for real. You look at what happened in the US between Netflix and Verizon as an example. That's a good combination of OTT and service providers. And we see that happening in Africa as well. And today was just a confirmation. The network has to be programmable. It has to be application aware to enable that business model. So that's one thing I wanted to comment on real quick. There was one topic. The other one is the future of how technology is adopted by different end user segments, different vertical industry, to basically connect processes, people, and things together. Something that is called Internet of Things, that we dub and rename as Internet of Everything, which is much more than connecting things together over broadband. It's actually about connecting people, things, and processes. And there was an interesting discussion today, triggered by a presentation from our head of system engineering and technology, and then expanding to multiple players about where Internet of Everything is going and what is the value. And I think much of the value on this connectivity of things, sensors, process, and people is actually in the service provider segment. So when you think about carriers, who today are used to provide connectivity, voice, and digital entertainment, and you think about their role in a world of 50 billion things connected, hyperconnectivity, where they specialize their offer to vertical markets like healthcare, like automotive, like agriculture, to bring a new level of efficiency by connecting everything to everything. Service providers will bring much more than connectivity in there. They will bring a platform that allows to do analytics, to process that amount of information and really extract value in a way that today is completely, non-accessible to service providers. So we believe Internet of Everything itself, being the trend for technology evolution, is also a key enabler for service providers to basically rejuvenate or innovate their business model. And this is what we've seen with a lot of traction in the discussion today at AfricaCom. Just to finish, the last big topic we've heard and we discussed actively as part of the panel was how to bring broadband in an affordable way to the 1 billion citizens in Africa as a continent. And of course there are the highly densely populated cities where the economics will fly. There are the rural areas, and there are the areas where simply a private investment will not be a viable model. So there's been a lot of discussion about PPP, private-public partnership. And again, when you think about what we have done as a company, Cisco, in terms of enabling open platforms, in terms of fiber access or broadband access, be it fiber or wireless based, enable open platform that allows service providers to monetize their investment, public investors to ensure equal access, and eventually have a more of a neutral technology model where differentiation happens at the service level, we believe that's a key enabler as well for private-public partnership. So I've seen a lot of alignment between technology, innovation and business model, the future vision of Internet of Everything, and it's really a vibrant environment that I didn't expect to find at this level of maturity, honestly, compared to what we have heard last year and 2 years ago in similar events. This is showing a much accelerated level of collaboration among parties and a different level of maturity.